Good morning, you guys. It is early in the morning. I don't even know why I'm recording this early. God, my hair still looks okay. Let me tell you something. This Myers Clean Multi-Surface Everyday Cleaner with Lavender Scent. I got through Amazon with my packages that y'all saw. This is just proof that just because something is natural, doesn't mean it's good for you. I sprayed down our kitchen, just the islander here, the island, 3 days ago. I immediately had a reaction. Granted, my asthma and allergies are inflamed right now, or flared. I don't know the right terms, girl. I was itchy. I started to itch. I had to wipe it down with vinegar and start all over. So I went on Amazon, and some of the 1-star, 2-star reviews complained about the scent and fragrance. So I contacted them and was like, refund. I need to return this shit because I just had a reaction. So they're like, oh, you don't have to send it back. Here's your refund right now. So I'm gonna see if one of my neighbors will take it, because no, I can't do this. Now, I use gold green, which is okay, but that set my allergies completely off. Isn't that funny? So anyway, it is Monday. And look, I've been getting up. Let me come over here and sit down. Where can I sit at, y'all? Because I really want to sit down. I'll just stand up for a little bit. It is Monday, and I have been in this space where I am stuck. Meaning, I am stuck where I want to do, what I want to do in life, and where I want to go. And I feel kind of, for lack of better words, I'm pissed off and upset with myself, because I'm actually in the middle of this series about purpose-driven, trying to, you know, figure out what the hell I want to do with my life, and I'm in a place to know where I'm stuck. I've done all my research, I've done all my homework, but then it's quiet. Do you know what I mean? Like, I'm like, what do I do from now? What do I do now? I have all the paperwork, I have all the meditation tapes and positive affirmations and shit. There's only so many, I'm sorry for cursing because I'm frustrated. There's only so many diagrams I could look at, and now I'm like, where do I go from here? One of the things I've been trying to do, which is really difficult for someone like me who's always on the go and always busy, and one of the suggestions that I read, was looking at a video on the guy who did, what is his name? He passed away a couple of years ago. He was the one that started the movement of projecting your future. You know, manifesting your future. He was the one that started it. And again, he passed away a couple of years ago. He was in his 70s. But one of the things he mentioned in a video is it's important to sit in silence, because silence cancels out silence. You don't have any noise going on. You're just there in your thoughts. So that's what I've been doing for the past week, every other day. It is so hard. When I tell you that's challenging for me, for someone who's a busybody, but to sit there with your own thoughts and even try to block some of that out and sit in silence, that's what I've been doing. That's the point where I am right now is, okay, I need to sit down, no to-do list, not even reading my Bible. Let me sit in silence for at least 5 minutes. Then I can meditate. Then I can read my Bible. Then I can stretch. You know what I mean? So I think that's what's really going to help me, you guys. We'll see. So anyway, y'all, not much going on this week. I do have a couple of videos to do. I think this will be up between this week and next week will be my last few videos for reviews, product reviews. And yeah, my friend's Wanda's birthday is this week. Still coughing. Her birthday is on the 30th, and so she has requested a cake. Now this is what she wants, girl. She wants a lemon pound cake with raspberry, some type of alcohol, and lemons. She's like, you're the only person I know who can pull it off. What the hell is wrong with these dogs? Dog's been barking all morning. Anyway, she's like, you're the only person I think that could pull it off. So I'm gonna make her that cake. I think the 30th is Thursday, so I'll make her the cake on Thursday, and I'll tape that for you guys. But I'm like, girl, but besides that, this week is gonna be pretty calm, so I'm gonna use this week to, like I said, after the meeting tomorrow at JB school, to go ahead and put together the curriculum. I did get an email last night from one of the, I don't know who it is, someone who clearly works at the school, saying that they need volunteers. They need assistance in the morning for the classes, but this is the thing. You just can't show up at that school. You have to go through a fingerprint clearance and then volunteer training. The fingerprint clearance or fingerprint card is $70 with the state. So I have to go through all of that and then go through the volunteer training just to show up and bring, you know, to help kids with the worksheets at school. Fine. So I'm gonna do that this week, at least submit my application for the fingerprint clearance card. So. These kids get one complete full day off on a Friday, what? And a half a day every month, like literally every month. And they have a fall break in October. It's like a whole week, girl. The winter break is 2 weeks. Then their spring break, and then of course there's, I'm like,
and a Halloween break.
That's considered a fall.
All right, y'all, hold on. Got home and one work email blew up into like 40 emails going back and forth. Y'all like my shirt? I don't know why I did that to my breast. Another update on my breast. Thank you to the person who said that they have eczema on their titties too, because I think that's what it is. I think I told you guys that the lower half of my breasts are itchy. The skin is kind of flaky, but not really, which I read is normal. However, I think it's eczema. So I ordered some, put in a prescription for my eczema cream, stopped by the pharmacy, and they're like, we don't have it. I said, well, girl, you need to go ahead and order it. I don't normally do crock pot meals. I don't know, I'm kind of indifferent when it comes to crock pot because I like to cook. I like to sear my meat. I like to look at it. I like to taste it and eat it. With a crock pot, you just dump everything in and go about your way. But because we have stuff going on throughout the day and I have somewhere to be this afternoon, I'm gonna be making a orange chicken crock pot meal. Let me tell you what I'm gonna do. Allergies, but I feel a lot better though. I have some chicken thighs in there with the skin on, gonna leave it on. I have some chicken breasts in there, and that'll be enough for us for about 2 to 3 days for lunch, for my husband's lunch and for me lunch, dinner, whatever. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna make my own sauce. Now I do already have some orange sauce already up in a bottle, but girl, we like to pimp it up. I add a lot more things to it. So I think I'm gonna do the rest of that celery, green onions, garlic, ginger, that sauce, soy sauce, chili paste, all that chicken, I know. Two potatoes and some carrots and some green beans. I know y'all, just extra for no reason, but I'm gonna show y'all how it's gonna be. It's gonna be good.
What time is it?
I'm gonna put it in now on low and it's gonna cook. Oh yes, girl, it's gonna cook. My husband said he needs to take back his pants. Let me tell you something, hold on. I think he's still asleep. Let me kind of be quiet. He is not gonna drive me crazy. Do you understand me? Let me tell you what he did. He ordered some pants, some dress pants. And again, this is all to get together our outfit, our ensembles for the banquet of the reunion. Because he told me a couple of weeks ago, my clothes fit funny. And I was like, you getting fat on me? What do you mean your clothes fit funny? He just doesn't like the fit of them. He likes a classic look, which is not as tight. Because nowadays, these men are wearing skinny, and then they have, they call it slim. Slim, and then super slim. And my husband's like, no, I gotta breathe. So, his dress pants came in 3 weeks ago, and he accidentally ordered super slim. I was like, oh, you're gonna be all tight up in the crotch area. You need to do something. So, we went online through JCPenney. JCPenney has tons of sale because I don't think they're getting a lot of business, and I know they have closed down some stores, like at least 50 stores nationwide. So they always have stuff on sale. So he found some slacks, and I told him, I said, you need to get a black dress shirt. He's like, but my suit is black. I said, you know what? Don't think about it. Just listen to me. I want you to do black. We're gonna do black on black. With my pink, I told y'all that black on black with my pink is gonna be sharp. I couldn't convince him to do a black tie. I couldn't convince him, but he's gonna do like a maroon tie. I'm like, that'll still be good. It'll be good. Long story short, girl, we gotta go back to JCPenney. We ordered everything online, but now he has to go back to JCPenney and return those skinny ass slacks. Girl, so today, this morning, I looked into Shaw. It's so uncomfortable, but it's important. It's something that you have to do, in my opinion. We made sure that we are listed as the beneficiary on our 401ks, and we both have life insurance through our jobs. However, I'm going to take it a step further, because what if we lose our jobs? I'm going to actually purchase life insurance outside of my work plan. And sometimes your work plan, I think a lot of us just select things. You know how you, it's December and they send out the mass emails to the company, select your damn benefits or you won't have any. So I just be selecting stuff and not really reading the fine print. And it's like $10 a month come out of my check. Well, I'm actually going to take the time. I started this morning and looking into life insurance for me, myself, and for Jabby. And it's really uncomfortable, but I told you guys that I'm in a wife group. And one of the reasons why I like this group is they do ask questions. And one young lady asked earlier this week, do you guys have life insurance on your family life insurance? And a couple of people were like, yes, absolutely, of course. And one girl shared that her friend a couple of weeks ago lost her 2-year-old child, and thank God that she had life insurance, because that's the last thing she wanted to think about was how are we going to pay for the funeral expenses and all of this stuff. So it's very uncomfortable, but it's a smart thing to do, and I've already been looking into it, and I got a quote, but I'm gonna shop around. My goal is to go ahead and have insurance and have it all done by October. That's my deadline. By mid-October, have it done. Because we're still doing that trip and all that, but by mid-October. And like I said, we have stuff through our job and we're still employed, but I like to have this as a cushion. Yeah, y'all, thinking about stuff like that, I do have advanced directives somewhere in my bag, but it hasn't been notarized. But now, those advanced directives are old. Those are at least, God, 10 years old. And now that I'm married and have had a child, I may want to change some things. You know, I may want to be on the ventilator. I may want to live a little bit longer now that I have a child. You see what I mean? These are things that are very uncomfortable. But once you get to a certain point in life, once you become an adult, you start to think about it and change it. Talking about. So yeah, y'all, just thinking about that, you know, and I encourage you, if you don't have that, have it. Because, oh, this is why I want to talk about it. Because Aretha Franklin didn't have a will. What the hell? And she knew she was sick. Like, how is it that, and it's something like I said, it's something that you don't think about. Hell, I'm 38 and I'm like, you know, tomorrow is not guaranteed. Have your stuff in order. By the time you 40 or 50, look, by the time you are 50, you better have something in order. You know what I mean? Like I said, we always had each other on a beneficiary for 401k and all that. And another thing to think about is that if you are a single parent, don't put your child down there, because that child may not be able to get it until they're 18. Put your parent down there and then put your child as secondary, you know? At least that's from what I understand. They can't get access to those funds till they're 18, you know? Because I know I even had to explain to my husband, and he was a little leery about this before we got married. I know he was. He had initially had his son down as the primary beneficiary. And I was like, your son, those you don't know, my husband has a child. He's 18 years old now, but at the time, he was like 14, 15. I'm like, your child is young. You need to put me down as primary and put him down as secondary, and I will take care of him. You know, I'll make sure he gets that money. And he trusted me then. That's why he married my ass. So yeah, I was like, yeah, that's what you should do. Long story short, girl, yeah, Aretha Franklin didn't have a will. And apparently Prince didn't have one either. That is crazy when you have millions and millions of dollars and don't have any plan for how that's all gonna be distributed once you're gone. Lord, y'all. So anyway, that's a very uncomfortable situation to be in, but it's something that has to be done. So anyway, y'all, I'm gonna go ahead and put all this stuff in the crock pot. What is it? Something else I was gonna tell y'all. I told JB I'll show up at school. He's so sweet, y'all, at school. And I need to get my nails done. Yeah, so Friday we have off, and Lori, Miss Lori, the lady that has the indoor daycare, she told me about it over the weekend. She reminded me of the weekend. And she's like, you guys should come over. So I said, okay. She said she's gonna have all the kids, so she wants me to come over there. So I said, okay. Meaning like she keeps like half the neighborhood kids, girl. Yeah, so I said, okay, at least I get to play with the baby. She has a little 1-year-old. He's so cute, y'all. I get all my baby cravings out the way. And so we'll go over there Friday. Let me back up. I'm gonna make my girlfriend cake on Thursday, girl. And this thing, you guys, like I told y'all, she had all these ideas with the cake. I'm like, Helpa, you are extra as hell. But I'm gonna do it and I'll show y'all what that looks like. So I'm gonna make her cake on Thursday. Friday, JB's off, so we're gonna go to Miss Lori's. And then we will probably go to the indoor playground we went to over the weekend, because that was so cute and he had a good time. He also didn't get a chance to do as much because he was following the other kids around. And then on the weekend, we are going to chill. Going to go to church on Sunday, because I haven't been to church in like 2 weeks. The birthday party was on last Sunday. So yeah, you guys, we're going to chill out and do that. I'm nervous about the curriculum meeting tonight, but it should be good. It should be good. I'm going to do a saline rinse here. I've been using JB's. He hasn't even used it. And frankly, you're not supposed to. Everyone's supposed to have their own. But there's ways. I mean, you can microwave the damn thing and disinfect it. But that really helped me. If you're starting to feel sick, allergies, sinusitis, rhinitis, nasal wash. And you can make your own saline rinse for your nose. Anyway, girl, let me put this stuff in the crock pot and get it going. Now, one of the things I'm going to do, because I don't like the way, unless it's a soup or tacos, I don't see how people do it. I don't like the way meat tastes in the crock pot. So I like it crispy. So what I'll do is I'll take the meat out. I'll probably put it up under the broiler for like 4 or 5 minutes so it crisps up. And I'll probably make some couscous to go on the side. But I do have a video that's on private. I'll probably make it available next month of some freezer meals I made before I had my surgery. Yeah, I did freezer soups and I still have some in there and I need to eat them because deadlines in 2 more months, girl. Freezer soups and freezer meats, and they did pretty good, but not my cup of tea, to be quite honest.
All right, y'all, so this is the chicken. I know, so I'm gonna wait, it's on low because we're gonna go run some errands to go meet boo boo for lunch. This is my chicken. I'll put in here, like I told y'all, nearly everything, girl. Onions, green bell pepper, garlic, ginger, onion powder, garlic powder, paprika, soy sauce, some of that orange sauce, and I don't want this to get mushy, even though it's on low. I'm reserving this. When I come back, I'm gonna add the potatoes. I'm gonna peel them, peel everything, add the potatoes and carrots. And then once it's almost about 75% there, I'm going to add the green beans and then take out all the chicken, put it on the broiler and serve it with some couscous. So I'll let y'all know how this turns out. This is my first time I'm making something like this. I think it may be a little bit too much liquid at first, so I'm just eyeballing it because the chicken's gonna produce some liquid too, and I'll take some liquid off so that this stuff doesn't get mushy, if that makes sense.
I'm about to fix myself a drink and a mayonnaise jar. Hold on, let me get some ice, girl. So I purchased this. First of all, we don't keep hard liquor in the at home. We only drink like margaritas when we're out to eat. And right now, we're gonna go out to eat now at this point. Once every other month, girl. So like once every 2 months, I'll have hard liquor. Not even that. And when I do, I have 2 drinks max. I purchased this Pinnacle Peak, which is a very low grade vodka, but I got it citrus. think it's Poland. Is this Poland French vodka? Girl, it's a French flag. It's a citrus flavor because this is gonna be for my friend's cake tomorrow, y'all. She's going to Vegas with a bunch of friends. So what I'm going to do is put this, y'all gonna see me make the cake, but I'm not gonna put, I'm trying to think of now if I wanna put, I don't wanna put liquor in the cake batter. I think that'd be too much. But the icing is going to have liquor. And then I'm going to make a raspberry puree type jam that they could actually put on the pound cake itself. And that's going to have vodka in it. And I'm going to give them this. I'm going to close it up, wrap it up, and tell them to put it in a trunk. Don't be having an open container in the front. And they can take this to Vegas with them. But I'm opening it up and pour me a drink. Let's see how much I do, y'all. Not a lot, and this is gonna be it, girl. That's a shot. Made me nice ice in here too. Then I have this lemonade. It's organic from Trader Joe's we got yesterday. Pour that on top. And then I have some lemon. Fresh lemon that I'm gonna wash. I remember in the 80s, people having like an area for their alcohol and entertainment. Girl, please. I have a bunch of barware, but it's for wine. I mean, I have stuff that I could use for that, but we're going to put this in the mayonnaise jar. I'm going to get a straw. Hold on. That is good, but I need something to cut that citrus. It's too sour. Add a splash of like a strawberry drink we had in there. That'll do. I'm gonna go ahead and make me some tacos now. we bought some roasted corn last night from Trader Joe's, and y'all know I love me some tacos. I'm gonna make me some bean and corn tacos. But real quick, we had the curriculum meeting at JB school, and it was very interesting to say the least. I don't understand why they didn't have this meeting in the beginning of the year, and it's very interesting to see that an overwhelming amount of parents had the same concerns I did, where their children have already gone to pre-K and now they're entering kindergarten and all of this stuff they already know. So what do you do? It seems like they used this entire month to test the children and then divide them up based on their needs. I just wish they would have had, like I said, I don't know if I said it, I wish they would have had this meeting at the beginning of the year as opposed to 4 weeks later. So they're going to have something what's called a flex schedule, which is where, and I mentioned this in my, this is going to be repetitive if you saw my chit chat video. So 15 minutes a day for learning arts, literature arts, and then for math, based on how they test it. At the beginning of the year, they will divide them into groups based on their skill level and work from there. One of the parents that I know, she was asking a lot of questions, and they got to a point to her, one of the teachers, in a very nonchalant PC way, was like, "You basically think your baby, don't do that. You basically think your child is smart, but she's not really as smart as you think she is." She didn't say that, but let me tell you what she said. The girl's parents was basically like, "Well, what do you do if they're already reading? Well, what if you do if they're already adding a subtraction?" She's like, "Well, we all learn at the same level, and then at the flex groups, it's a time where we divide up." So they're basically, they're not really learning anything new. And so the teacher was basically like, "Well, you know, we have a lot of parents who think that their children can actually read when in fact they've just memorized books. And there's nothing wrong with being, you know, with being a little slow, especially at the," she didn't say slow. "It's nothing wrong with learning at a slower level." She's like, "You know, basically I was behind a grade, and look at me now. You know, I'm a teacher, you know, and I think I'm pretty smart, and I have an actual master's degree." I just got the notion of, and I think one of them even said it, "We don't want them." this is the feeling I got, and a couple other parents agreed with me. "We don't want them to be advanced at this level, at this age. We want them to be even out. Now, if they do better, then yes, we can offer some things to challenge them, but we want everyone basically to be on an even playing field. That is the, I was a little upset when I got out of the meeting. One of the moms texted me today and said that they're gonna keep their child there, but they're already applying for another school. And once she gets past the wait list there, they're gonna pull her. Phoenix has one of the worst school districts in the country. That's been a huge downside for me as a parent of a small child. And JB goes to a charter school, by the way. There's no way I'm putting him in a public school. Most of the better schools are in the Tempe area. We live in North Phoenix, on the outskirts of Phoenix, excuse me. So I spoke to my husband about it. I said, you know, I'm gonna give these teachers a benefit of the doubt, okay? I'm not one of those parents that's like, well, I can do better than this, you know? I can do it all myself. However, I am listening to my intuition, but I'm also respecting the perspective of a teacher. They've gone to school for this. A lot of them have gone to graduate school. So clearly, I'm gonna trust them at this point. I'm not gonna be rash, pull my child out like some of them are doing. I'm gonna give them a chance, okay? I'm gonna have to add some challenging things for JB. So today I stopped by the Dollar Tree and I picked up some Common Core workbooks for first grade level because he already knows how to count to 20. That's one of the goals of kindergarten. He already knows his alphabet. And JB said to me yesterday, which was a clear sign, he said, you know what, mommy? I was reading at my other school and I'm not reading at this school. What is it, baby?
I can't put my
shoes. Oh, sorry, y'all. Okay, sweetheart. Mommy will help you. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. Like I said, I think that as a parent, you know, we all have our concerns with our children, but I also think that we need to be able to trust, you know, the administrators and the teachers, because it's not an easy job to do, especially at this age. 5-year-old and 6-year-old girl, yeah.
All these brushes.
You clean my, who told you to touch my Felicia leather with brush? He said I cleaned your brush.
And you cleaned my.
I'm trying to finish detangling my hair, y'all. So my friend is coming by tonight and she requested, those of you who saw my previous vlog, or I think I mentioned it earlier in this vlog, my friend wants me to make her a pound cake and she wants alcohol drizzled throughout it. And so this is an original recipe by me. I have 2 boxes of lemon Supreme. Now these are different. That's Betty Crocker, this is Duncan Hines. But it's both lemon, okay, it's okay. And then I'm gonna add some pudding. I'm gonna do 1/2 a stick of butter. I'm gonna eyeball the oil, I don't know. I'm gonna add in some good quality vanilla, some lemon extract, and 4 eggs. I think I'm gonna do 4 eggs because it's gonna be a pound cake. Y'all, this is the cake. I don't feel like taking it out. That's how lazy I am. Y'all know I'm not good at decorating cakes, but this is what it's gonna be. There's 5 shots of vodka between the cake and the jam here. Oh my God, y'all. So that is it.